Welcome back, everybody. Lately, we've been doing a lot and covering a lot of stories about the value of a practical education. Just to tell you what that means is the idea that when you go to school, that you really go to school for a purpose, or you return to school with a specific purpose, and that getting a practical education allows you to get the kind of instruction you need to hit the ground running. Well, there's probably no better example than this than what my generation remembers as BOCES, which is now referred to as CTE, Career and Technical Education. And joining me today are two instructors involved with the CTE Center here in Saratoga, and that's Maureen Clancy, who's the executive chef, as if we couldn't tell, instructor at CTE, and Jeff Rescott, who's a heating ventilation instructor. Well, welcome, both of you.
Thank you. Very nice to have you here.
Nice to be here.
You know, I can't tell you. It must be the temperament, must be the people we interview, must be the area we live in. The whole thought of a practical education, it just seems like a no-brainer to me, Maureen. You know? And now, you've got an interesting story, because 30-odd years ago, you went through a training program, went off into the world, came back, and now you're the executive chef instructor.
That's right. It's been a long time. A long journey. When I first started out, it was called food trades and food services, and now it's career and technical education, and our program is culinary arts and hospitality. So it's changed quite a bit. It's rigorous curriculum, and also the state demands quite a bit of attention on the programs, their certifications, and also to get out in the world and learn those skills that you need to get a job.
Yeah, got it. You know, it. We're going to delve into the certification. I want to go back on a couple of things, but Jeff, I want to get you in here. The HVAC category, boy, you're talking about a practical category like automotive, right?
Right.
This is a very practical application. You went through the program yourself, both of you did.
Yeah.
You came back, and now you're an instructor.
Correct. Yeah, it's one of the things we have in common, the two of us, but it's pretty neat that I can remember, you know, years ago when I went to BOCES and the impact they had on my life, and I still remember the teachers and what they did, and they go out of their way to help you out. But I think the biggest thing I liked was working with my hands and learning how to be able to build things and take things apart and put them together is something I liked, and now sharing it with students. It's a pretty neat thing.
Yeah, you know, you're also very passionate about both of them. Before we went on air, we were talking about it, and it just really shows. You know, I happen to be one of the people that went through college way back when and graduated and went, okay, now what? You know, and outside the fact you're saddled with student loans or whatever, you know, you're thinking to yourself, there has to be an option here. There has to be an alternative
right.
here. You know, tell me a bit about culinary. We all think of it, of course, in terms of being a chef and cooking and whatever. But you said something interesting to me, that a real practical education in this category involves the front of the house.
The front of the house and the back of the house.
And involves the kitchen, right?
It does.
So in front of the house, what does that mean?
It means you've got to be out there in front with the people, customer service, learning all the different management areas that you need to successfully run your business.
Yeah, sure.
I mean, you could be in the back making the best food in the world, but if you can't get the food out to the customers in a timely manner or not insulting customers, you know, then it's not worth it and your business will probably fold.
You know, many people tell you in that category that everyone in the front of the house is the ambassador.
They are.
You know, and that if the ambassador doesn't do a good job of welcoming someone, making sure that the details are taken care of, then you're right, you could be creating the best food in the world. Now, talking about the best food in the world, what about the kitchen?
The kitchen has to also have good safety sanitation practices. They need to have management skills. They need to know time management, how to listen, pay attention to details. There's a lot involved. And they need to learn to get along with their wait staff. That's a big thing. You know, you can't have the Gordon Ramsays out there that are screaming and yelling and throwing plates of food and expect, you know, people to survive that kind of atmosphere. So
the skill set that you would learn in the kitchen, of course, is everything. Can you make s'mores? You know I was going to ask you that.
I know.
You know I was.
We can even make them and deconstruct them for you.
Oh, good. But you know what? You think about the different categories, whether it's sautéing or whether it's grilling or whether it's pasta, right? I mean, I'm just thrown it out here as a weekend warrior cook, but all of those are very disciplined skills, right?
Yes, they are.
Yeah.
And each individually has an importance in it, but it all is connective.
Connected to the whole.
It is.
Now, Jeff, HVAC, again, I slipped out weekend warrior. I've done it all, including getting shocked and thrown across the room. A lot of safety issues in this, right? And also, that skill set, you have to have a lot of practical knowledge. You have to really know what you're doing in order to get certified, right?
Right. Well, the first thing you do is when you have students come in, you've got to make sure they're going to be safe. You know, parents aren't too happy if you send the kids home injured. So, you know, we take care of all the safety stuff, make sure the kids know how to handle the power tools and the threading tools and, how to work with electricity without getting hurt. You know, talk about the fire extinguishers, where they are, little things like that. So, you know, the biggest thing is getting them prepared to learn. Mm-hmm. That's a big thing. And then the learning process comes after.
Yeah, I bet. And of course, that's really hands-on.
It is.
That is really hands-on. You know what? We're talking about, I didn't bring all these categories. How many categories? Something like 17 different?
17 different program areas.
Programmings. Just help me out here. I left my notes inside. But it's everything from cosmetology to farming to heavy equipment to culinary arts to HVAC to automotive, all different areas of automotive. And the program works if you're in the 11th grade or the 12th grade, you spend half a day at CTE and it's free. You're not paying for the expertise that the instructors have. And by the time you graduate high school, you're also certified in a specific trade. And for those of us that are either weekend warriors or would like some adult education, for a very small tuition, you can go to one of the career and tech education centers, either here in Saratoga or in Hudson Falls, and learn a trade or expand on that trade, right?
That is right, yeah.
Well, you know, in the era that we're living in right now, I don't understand anything else. I don't understand how anything else could be more rewarding or more practical, right?
It's a great program.
You've been involved for 30 years, and you've been involved for 16 years. Now, there's an open house coming up, originally scheduled for tonight, but it is going to be next Tuesday, which is the 24th, 6 to 8 p.m., right here in the Saratoga Center on Henning Road, right?
That's right.
Look for the big equipment. They got a lot of big industrial equipment out front, but a beautiful center. 6 to 8 p.m. on Tuesday the 24th. I highly recommend that if you're in high school, you're a parent of a student in high school, and you take a run over there, meet these people. It's very impressive. And again, understand that in any number of different categories, you're getting a terrific leg up on understanding what it's like to learn a trade and the practical application in the field.
It's true.
Yeah.
Students in our programs get a chance to learn all the basics they need to be employable. And secondly, they also get a chance to do internships in their industry.
Right.
And then upon that, most of those people in the industry hire those interns. Mm-hmm. So and then they get certified. So it's a win-win situation.
It certainly is. That's how a lot of people in our industry get a start, is that they show up as interns with being conscientious, having a knowledge base to start with, and then they're learning in the field with us. And I'm sure the same thing happens in your categories.
Equally important, the students are all recognized in a lot of the local colleges and state colleges, and we have articulation agreements with them to help them out as well.
Boy, all right. The 24th, Tuesday the 24th, 6 to 8 p.m. at the CTE Center, BOCES, out on Henning Road, right here in Saratoga. Highly recommend you go there, check it out, see what's going on there. Thank you both very much for coming
in.
Very nice to meet you and
talk
with you.
Very nice to meet you.
Thank you.
To see this interview again, you can head to our website, looktvonline.com.